In this example, we want to determine the exact value of tangent pi over 8 using a half angle identity. And notice that we have three options for the half angle identity for tangent. In this video, I'm going to use this last identity because I think it has the simplest denominator. And I think it's usually easier to apply these identities if our angle is in degrees. So let's start by converting pi over 8 radians into degrees. So we'll multiply by 180 degrees divided by pi. So notice how the pi's simplify out. 8 and 180 have a common factor of 4. There's two 4s in 8, and there's 45 4s in 180. So this gives us 45 degrees divided by 2, or 22.5 degrees. So let's rewrite this as tangent 22.5 degrees, and then we'll double the angle to identify the value of A used here, as well as here on the right side, which we actually had here before we divided. This is the same as tangent 45 degrees divided by 2. So A is equal to 45 degrees. Now we'll go ahead and apply this identity. This function value is equal to 1 minus cosine 45 degrees divided by sine 45 degrees. And we should already be familiar with this function value from the 45, 45, 90 triangle, where the two legs are 1 and the hypotenuse is square root 2. So the sine of 45 degrees is equal to 1 over square root 2, which rationalizes to square root 2 over 2. And because this is an isosceles right triangle, the cosine of 45 degrees is the same, 1 divided by square root 2, which rationalizes to square root 2 divided by 2. So we can rewrite this as 1 minus square root 2 over 2 divided by square root 2 over 2. Let's start by multiplying the numerator and denominator by 2 to clear the fractions in the numerator and denominator. So when we do this, our numerator is going to be 2 minus, again, you can think of this as 2 over 1 if you want. So these 2 simplify out. So we have 2 minus the square root of 2 divided by, same thing in the denominator, these 2's simplify out. So we're left with square root 2. So the last thing we probably want to do is rationalize the denominator. So let's go ahead and rewrite this. We have 2 minus square root 2 all over square root 2. And now we'll multiply the denominator by square root 2 and the numerator by square root 2. So we're going to have 2 square root 2 and then minus 2 divided by 2. And then we can rewrite this as 2 square root 2 all over 2 minus 2 over 2, which simplifies nicely to square root 2 minus 1. Remember, when you're dividing by a monomial or one term, we can break it up into individual fractions. So the exact function value of tangent pi over 8 radians is equal to square root 2 minus 1.